गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माइसेल्फ शिवानी, योर अकाउंट्स टीचर। टुडे वी लर्न द अकाउंटिंग फॉर GST, मींस गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज टैक्स। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द अकाउंटिंग ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विस टैक्स, फर्स्टली एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज टैक्स। GST इज एन इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स लेविड और चार्ज एट द प्रिस्क्राइब रेट ऑन एवरी सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज एक्सेप्ट कस्टम ड्यूटी, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, टैक्सेज ऑन पेट्रोलियम, टैक्सेज ऑन एल्कोहलिक ड्रिंक्स एंड टैक्सेज लेविड बाय द लोकल बॉडीज। ऑल टैक्सेज हैव बीन मर्ज इन टू ए सिंगल टैक्स, दैट इज GST. GST Act was passed in the Parliament on the 24th March 2017 and it came into effect from 1st July 2017. It is a nationwide tax, means one nation, one tax. It has replaced many indirect taxes levied by the central state governments. It includes VAT, CST, excise duty. In other words, previously you would have maintained individual account for VAT, excise, CST, other services, taxes with a separate input, output and credit entries for each. GST is paid on the purchase of goods and services is known as input GST and it is collected from customers on the sale of goods and services is known as output GST. GST paid on purchase is not a cost for the purchaser, but it is an asset since it can be set off against the GST collected on sales. Means input GST adjusted against output GST. On the other hand, GST collected on sale, output GST, is not an income of the seller, but it is a liability. There are certain cases in which GST paid cannot be set off against GST collected. In such cases, GST paid on purchase is a cost for the purchase, and following are the cases when the GST purchase of goods and services cannot be set off against GST collected. These cases are food and beverages expenses, purchase of vehicles, free gift to staff, payment for health insurance, repair and maintenance of building and any asset, payment of membership fees, payment for goods services for personal use, etc. Input GST is credited in the following cases. While at the time of purchase, purchase account is debited, input GST is debited. But some cases, input GST is credited. These cases are purchase return, goods taken by the proprietor, goods lost or stolen, goods destroyed, goods distributed as a free sample, goods given away as a gift or charity. On the other hand, when the sales goods and services, sales account is credited and output GST is credited. But one case in which output GST is debited, that case is of sales return. Following goods are and services are exempt from levy of GST, means certain cases in which GST is not applied. That cases are payment of wages and salary, supply of services to government or to embassies of other country, electricity and water bills, educational services, health services, traveling expenses, and interest. Thank you.